it, and you got four guys down the stuff. I got Greg Stass and them guys down there.
Adrian Belew on guitar. No, spotlight there. Hey, there you go, Adrian. Tommy Mars on keyboards. Up there. Hey, very good. Little skinny Terry Ted Bozzio on drums. The leopard encrusted, direct from Vienna, Peter Wolf on keyboards. And our one and only percussoid, ladies and gentlemen, Ed Mann. And I'm your host for tonight, Ted Nugent. Baby, wait a minute. Have you ever seen one of these things? No, look, this guy. Like that? Figured you would. Name of this song is Peaches En Regalia. We'll be right back. so all green and fuzzy. There's nice grumble and kiss that goes. Scratch their mighty hands. A tiny light from a window hole, 100 yards away, is all they ever get to know about the regular life in the day. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking. In the room where the giants fly above the woods, and the torture never stops now. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops. Spikes and guns and the likes over every tool of hay. And a sinister midget with a bucket and a mop where the blood goes down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking and weeping through the scraps. In the room where the giant fire above the works, and the torture never stops. An evil prince eats a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. He eats the snouts and the trotters first, the loins and the groins is soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. He stands and shouts, all men be cursed. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. All men be cursed. And disagree well. He's the best of course of all the world.
He's the best of course of all the world.
Some wrong been done, you've done it first.
Some wrong been done, you've done it first.
And it stinks so bad, his bones been choking. And he's been in the night of the iron sausage, where the torture never stops, yeah. The torture never stops. The torture. The torture. The torture never stops.
Everybody get tortured now.
Thank you.
Thank you. hey, I wish I was dead. Somebody tell me, why am I living? Now I wanna be dead. Stay here, that's what I said.
Storm. Down in Flakes.
The people see.
That's the people's see.
That's the people see.
And it's over there. Thank you.
The subject of incompetence. This is specifically about the incompetence of people in California. Because as you know, if you've ever been there and tried to get anything done on time, there's nobody in California that works for a living. They're all on welfare. And if they aren't on welfare, they wish they were on welfare, and that's why you can't get them to do anything. And that's why we have this song called Flakes.
Swear to God they got the bones, they never built this on the bones. Swear to God they got the bones, they never built this on the bones.
They got the bones.
Fight, fight!
You can't fix your brakes. You ask them, where's my motor? When it was eaten by snakes. Stab and shoot and spit, but they won't be fixing it. Lying and lazy, they can be driving you crazy.
Swear to God they got the bones, they're in business on the coast. Swear to God they got the bones, they're in business on the coast.
I ask as nice as I could, if my job would somehow be finished by Friday. Well, the whole damn weekend came and went, Frankie.
Yeah, it's the shits, ain't it, Bob?
You know what? They didn't do nothing. But they charged me double for Sunday. Now, you know, no matter what you do, they're gonna cheat and rob you.
That's right.
And then they'll give you a bill that'll get your senses reeling. If you do not pay, they got computer collector.
That's his loud protest.
That'll get you so crazy till your head will run through the ceiling. Yes, it will.
Thank you. little bit weird in the front part, but later on, you know, it moves faster. So I guess for about the first 32 bars, you can fill it out a little bit. And then when it goes faster, you can tap your feet and maybe dance, you know what I mean? The name of this song is Envelopes.
Thank you. there's no one to treat you right. And you dance, tell me that it is now as long as we do this world.
Oh! in several locations. I'm kissing quite a bit.
Here's a boy, here's a girl, with the girls on beach and snow.
blackest night, there was no moon in sight. You know the stars ain't shining, cause the sky's too tight. There's a scary wind that beats some ugly trees. There was a werewolf hawking along the side of me. I'm mean and I'm bad, you know I ain't no sissy. Got a big titty girl in the side of me. Chrissy, puffing the powder in my back. And this ride up the mountain of Mr. Peaches, please. Oh, yeah. I noticed even the crickets acting weird up here. And so I figured I might just drink a little beer. I said, give me some of that, what you're sucking on. But there was no reply, oh, she was gone. With those titties I like so well. And my goddamn beer is what I started to yell. And I heard this noise like a bunch of wheel. The devil, he's about this big. He had a red suit on and a widow's peak and then a pointed tail and like a sofa wheel. Yes, it was him all right, I swear I know it was. He had some human flesh stuck underneath his claws. You know it looked to me like it was kitty skin. I said, you son of a bitch, cause I was mad at him. Well, he just got out his floss and started cleaning his fangs. So I shot him with my shooter set. Bang, 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 and the sucker just laughed and said, put it away, you know I hate all of what you gonna say? You ain't my Chrissy?
Yeah!
The titties and all! Well, what about the beer then?
Now, what can't miss off?
Even her boots?
Now, would I lie to you?
Since you must have been hungry.
Yeah! This is true!
Well, don't they pay you good for the stuff that you do?
Well, you know, I can't complain when the checks come through!
Well, I want my Chrissy,
yeah.
And I want my beer, so you just bob it back up. Now, devil, do you hear?
Blow it out your ass, motorcycle fan! I mean, I am the devil!
Do you understand?
Yes. Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you notice this little clock out here.
You're goddamn right, you son of a whore. That's the only reason I learned that.
Oh, right, too.
Give me that paper. Get your butt outside, because I need a beer and it's titty squeezing time.
Hold on a second, you can't fool me! You ain't that bad, man! You should have seen some of the soul that I had! Why, there was Bill Hall's pictures and Acme too! And both of those suckers was worse than you!
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true. I mean, you're supposed to be the devil, so what you gonna do?
Well, maybe we can make a deal, but, you know, these clothes you're wearing, man, they just ain't my style. I mean, you know, how come you don't wear skin-tight stretch pants and a headband and wrist things like Ted Nugent, the Motor City Batman? He's my style. He's the kind of guy I signed a contract with. Aren't we? You know what I mean?
Hey, well, listen, if Nugent's your style, then take him to the Tower of Power.
Well, what does that have to do with you? Me and you and your girlfriend, no matter.
Hey, look, it's very simple. Look, you're trying to tell me that you're the devil, you know?
Right.
All I can see right now is that you're into rubber.
This is true. The tight brand rubber.
That's yeah, well, you know. I don't know what to say about a person who's into rubber. I always thought you were into leather, you know. I could dig it if you were into it.
They go hand in hand.
Flowers. How cute. Thank you.
I'm not into flowers.
Not into flowers?
No.
I see.
Somebody else.
Oh, some more flowers. Oh, my goodness.
What is this? San Francisco, 1966?
Peace, love, eternal cosmic wisdom.
Listen, man. Tell me something. I mean, I'll give you your girlfriend back, you know, if you sign a contract. But first, man, let me know what your interests are, you know, because I don't let just anybody into hell. You gotta be weird, you know, so
hey,
tell me where you're at, man.
Look, just because I come to Detroit once a year don't mean I'm weird.
That's
you know?
True.
If you want to see something weird, look at those suckers out there. They live here.
Yeah. Can you put the lights on?
Look, I'll tell you what. I'll make you a deal. You give me back my girlfriend and that beer, and you can have all of them. Because all I ever really wanted was titties and beer, 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 titties and beer.
No, don't sign it then. Give me time to think. I mean, hold on a second, boy.
biggest rock promise all around the world, she said. Then she gave him the finger and was rigid stiff. That's when the devil, he farted, and she went right over the cliff. The devil was mad, I just got through my bed. I swear I do be glad, I'll make you get back then. Swear I do be glad, I'll make you get back then. Swear I do be glad, I'll make you get back then. Swear I do be glad, I'll make you get back then. Right. Ladies and gents, it's instrumental time at the ranch once again. Why we dare to play this instrumental in this particular town is because Detroit has always had a history of what you might say is progressive radio. I've been here before, and I've listened to some of the things that you people get to hear on the radio. And believe me, you're ready for this. You're ready for this one. The name of this song is The Black Page Number 2. It's a little bit erudite, but don't let that bother you. It features Ed Mann on percussion, Peter Wolf on keyboards, Tommy Mars on keyboards, Adrian Belew on guitar, Patrick O'Hearn on bass, and of course the devil himself, little skinny Terry Ted Bozzio on drums. So watch closely now, The Black Page Number 2.
hearts of a rascal, broken hearts of a rascal, you're an asshole too. What's it gonna do? Cause you're an asshole. You think you're a lonely guy? Maybe you think you're too tough to cry. But you went to the grave just to give it a try.
Back on the ugliest sucker bitch I've ever seen in my life.
What is his bad?
Leather. The whisker sticking out underneath of his pancake
makeup
is not on sale tonight.
Nearly broke you in Saturday.
The Motor City Madman.
Just the little sailor is a hobo who had just flew in from Spain.
Charwell.
Pull the chain attached to the crumbly erected nipples of
Jimmy is a hobo. In a bold salute to Pat.
And our own Reverend Bundle.
He the reeking bonds of angel.
The Banana Peak is a hobo.
Like it was okay.
Sir Lorian is a homo.
That legs that you got to a go-go.
He's about to land.
In a way you can't explain.
Eiffel Tower of power.
So you work the wall with Michael.
50 watts of continuous power. Running through the spindle. Rotating at 35 RPM.
With a gong show.
A salute to pain.
You forgot what I was saying. Cause you're an asshole, you're an asshole. You're an asshole, you're an asshole.
That's right.
You're an asshole, you're an asshole.
And you,
you're an asshole, you're an asshole.
Yeah.
But now you think you're the champ, you think you're the great, and now I think you know what you are. You're an asshole.
You can live with what you've been through. But ladies, you can be an asshole too. I think you ain't got one on the bottom of you.
On the bottom of you.
Don't fool yourself, girl. Looking at you. Don't fool yourself, girl. Looking at you. Don't fool yourself, girl. Looking at you.
That's why I'm saying.
Such case is seated before you, none other than little skinny Terry Ted Bozzio. Terry recently fell in love with a publicity photo of a boy named Punky Meadows, lead guitar player from a group called Angel. In the photo, Punky was seen with a beautiful shiny hairdo in a semi-profile which emphasized the bootstrap succulence of his insolent loving rictus. The sight of which drove the helpless young homo mad at a desire.
But he might not be pouting for me.
You realize the Motor City Madman is a homo?
Oh no, Puffy, not him too.
They're so shiny and stuck real nice till I scream with ecstasy.
Thank you.
Now, I'll follow
Tommy Mars, Terry Bozzio, Peter Wolf, and Mann. Thanks for coming to the concert. Good night. She looked over at me with a glazed eye and some bovine perspiration on her upper lip area, and she said, just get me wasted, and you're halfway there. Cause if my mind's tore up, well then my body don't care. I rubbed my chinny chin chin and said, my, my, my. What sort of thing might this lady get high upon? The $40 bill didn't matter no more when her sister got naked and laid on the floor. She said, Dinah-Moe might win the bet, but she could use a little if I wasn't done yet. I told her just because the sun got a place in the sky, no reason to assume I wouldn't give her a try. So I pulled on her hair, got her legs in the air, and asked her if she had any cooties in there.
What do you mean cooties? No cooties on me.
She was buns up kneeling. I was wheeling and dealing.
Wheeling and dealing.
She surrendered to the feeling.
She surrendered to
the feeling. She started to squeal. Dinah-Moe watched from the edge of the bed with her lips just a twitching and her face gone red. Some drool rolling down from the edge of her chin while she spied the condition her sister was in. She quivered and quaked and clutched at herself. Her sister made a joke about her mental health until Dinah-Moe finally did give in. But I told her all she really needed was some discipline. I said, kiss my aura. Aura. Because it's real Angola. Would y'all like some aura? Right here on the floor. All right. One more time. This time, clap your hands.
insinuations coming from the distillation of Dinah-Moe Humm. As I get down, stroll on over, says, look at mom, got a bullet out there, says, you can't make me come. You just can't do it. She did a bit for the sisters, a little bit dumb, and you couldn't get a time on people's shelves. I don't mind that you call me mom, cause if you got a race, it's really gonna come. So I got down to it. Whipped up a boomers and a lip of my bum and a fly rotation of a cigarette bomb. I poked this stroke till my wrist got numb and you know I heard some Dinah-Moe Humm. Dinah-Moe Humm. Dinah-Moe. Little Dinah-Moe. Little Dinah-Moe. Dinah-Moe. Little Dinah-Moe. 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 Dinah-Moe.
Dinah-Moe, all right, hey, 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 hey. All right, look, I'll make you a deal. We'll play another song if you guys will back up. We would appreciate that very much. What's your name? This girl up here wants me to say hi to her mother. Her name is Bianca. Hi, Bianca. Now please move back. Especially you guys right here, back. All right. Now back. Hey, look. Bring it down to a mild rumble. I really would like to play something else for you, but I have no intention on causing any injury to anybody out there. Now please move back. Back, back, back. Put the spotlights down here so you see them moving back. Thank you, I appreciate this. Oh, hi, Brianna. That's her name. That's right. Okay. Okay, now back. Now back. Back, back, back. Okay. Now, since you're being so entirely cooperative with our program here tonight, except for you, you're not being cooperative enough, get down there. Get down, Detroit! I mean, get down, Detroit. Now, get down, Detroit! Okay. Okay, get down! All right, the name of this song is Camarillo Grillo. Yeah. 1, 2, 3, 4. She had that Camarillo Grillo. That's right. I mean, I've never seen no vino. I went some months of getting red. She rolled her toes in these old bars. Every week in Idaho, get down. And every frickin' black boilers. By the brooks in Buffalo. She said she was a magic mama. And she could draw me tarot. And carry on without a comma. But she was someone I should know. She had a snake full of pep and a mammy lip. And she was beating and pouring, but she wasn't done yet. She had great skin, and I was the bit. I told her she was all right, but I couldn't come in. Actually, I was very busy then. And so she wandered through the doorway, smacked a shadow from the tomb. She said her stereo was four-way. I just love it in a room. Well, I was born to have adventure, so I just followed up the step.
went past the puny and sensed danger. To where she hung a castanet. She took away her rancid poncho and laid out naked by the door. We couldn't tell we were unconscious, and it was useless anymore. She had a snake for a pet and a man who let, and she was beating it hard, but she wasn't done yet. She had breaking skin. I thought with a bit, I told her she was alright, but I couldn't come in. Hey, is that a real poncho or a serious poncho? And so she wandered through the doorway, just like a shadow from the tomb. She said her stereo was four-way. Get down, Detroit! And oh God, I would love it up in a room. Well, I was born to have adventure, so this is adventure. So I just followed up the steps. Get down, Detroit. Down, right past her fuming incense stencher. To where she hung her castanets. I chewed my way through her rancid panocha. She lay buck naked by the door. We didn't tell we were unconscious, and it was useless anymore. Yes, it was useless anymore. All right, now look. Wait, we ain't done yet, but we're gonna be done a lot faster unless you guys move back. Hey, look. I mean, do I really look like Mick Jagger or what? Get off the stage. Back.
Back Luma. Simba Ungawa.
Okay, now look. One more if you'll move back.
Thank you.
Adrian Belew, Patrick O'Hearn, Tommy Marr, Darren Bozzio, Peter Wolf, Ed Mann. And my name's Flakes, and good night.